Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So, okay, so we were doing the classification of we were on this part. So we were doing classifications of PD. And we have already classified PDs into the elliptical PDs, parabolic PDs, and hyperbolic PDs. Out of that, we have seen the examples of the PD that is called as hyperbolic PD. Okay, this is done. Second, we have seen the parabolic PD. Parabolic PD. And next we'll be going to look at elliptical PD. Now we have seen why this classification was important. This classification tells us what will be the solution, okay, type of the solution. Next, it talks about the, I will change the color, type of the solution. Then it talks about the boundary condition, where to give boundary condition, okay, location of boundary condition, location of boundary condition. This is second thing, and the third thing is the domain of dependence. Okay, so that I am going to tell later. Domain of dependence. Domain of dependence. So we have seen hyperbolic cases. The solution was. In hyperbolic cases, the solution was real-life and the location of boundary condition was inflow boundary condition and domain of dependence described by the characteristics curves. In parabolic PD, the solution was of the type which is called as the diffusion type of solution. And the location of the boundary conditions where like you have to give the initial conditions in a time and boundary conditions at every boundary. And no boundary condition at the future time. And the domain of dependence for any time, all the values which are lesser than that domain. Again, it is described by the characteristic curve. Okay. Again, characteristic curve describes the domain of dependence. In elliptic PDE, okay, what are the examples of elliptic PDE? We'll just see on the similar mode, which we used to do for hyperbolic PDs and parabolic PDs. Example of PDE is our well-known conduction equation. Say for example, if T is the temperature in the domain, 2D domain, okay. In that case, this example is a kind of elliptic. We can check for that V square minus 4AC whether it is greater than 0, less than 0. These conditions we can check based on the coefficients of this higher order derivatives A, C, and from that we can check whether it is an elliptic PDE or not. Okay. Now, our basic aim is a solution type. Okay. So, what is the solution type for this PDE? The solution is basically called as the equilibrium solution. Okay. Equilibrium इक्विलिब्रियम सॉल्यूशन, इक्विलिब्रियम सॉल्यूशन. व्हाट डज इट मीन बाय इक्विलिब्रियम सॉल्यूशन? इट मींस दैट द गवर्निंग पेशेंट दिस पीडीईज आर dependent upon the boundary conditions that x is equals to some value at x and y. Okay, so the PDE, the solution t of this PDE, is continuously dependent upon the boundary conditions at x and y. Okay, so that is how it is like a GUI problem. Suppose we have a domain of this nature. These are all straight lines. Now this is the x direction, and suppose this is the y direction. Then in that case, the boundary conditions at this lower boundary and upper boundary, and the left boundary and the right boundary. Okay. So the solution at this point will be dependent upon all these boundary conditions. Okay. Solution at here, at any point in the domain, will be continuously dependent, governed by the boundary condition. Okay. It has to follow the boundary conditions. So that is what the meaning of the equilibrium solution. So here, whatever the value needs to be come here, it will be forced by these boundary conditions. So these boundary conditions act like a jury. Okay, acts like a somebody who is watching on the solution and forcing it to do. So this is also called a jury solution. Okay. But does it mean that it is a steady state solution? No. Okay. Here in the domain, there may be some variable. Here there can be some variable which can be a function of x, y, and also time. Okay, but the solution here, there is no evolution of the solution with initial conditions. There are no initial conditions at time. There is no time variable derivative comes here, where it shows the evolution of the solution, evolution of the solution in time. Okay, so you don't have to specify initial time level values and progress toward next level of time. Next level of time, there is no necessity. However, such a necessity was there in case of hyperbolic problems and parabolic problems. In hyperbolic problems and parabolic problems, you used to start with initial t is equals to zero condition, and with that condition, you used to progress in time, marching in time. It's like marching, same word coming from military. You used to march in a particular direction. Okay. So marching direction. Here there is no marching direction. Okay. So these are completely different regimes. This white color hyperbolic, parabolic, and red color elliptic, they are completely different in nature. Okay. Hyperbolic and parabolic, they have a marching kind of direction. And elliptical PDEs do not have marching direction, but they essentially depends continuously, solution depends continuously on the boundary conditions described. Okay. That is what it means. So they, it means that, what does it mean? That there is no time marching. Time marching or space marching. Space marching. What does it mean? Neither in the time direction you march, okay, or in the space direction also you do not march. Okay. You do not seem to march in a kind of in a straight direction. So no marching, time marching and space marching. Okay. So these problems, for example, for this particular case of PDE, d2 t by dx2 plus d2 t by d by 2, and suppose we have a boundary conditions over this domain. In this left domain, suppose we have temperature T value over all this wall, complete wall, over throughout this wall, if it is T is equals to 0, and say T is equals to 1 over all these values. Okay, this is non-dimensional temperature, for example, and non-dimensional x and non-dimensional y, so there is no unit now given. And suppose we have an insulation on the top upper wall and bottom wall. Okay, so in this case, the solution has to show that behavior. So see the solution, how the solution will look like. Then you have a domain, this domain, same domain. The solution will have to satisfy the boundary conditions. Here it should satisfy the zero value. Here it should satisfy the zero value of temperature, and here it should satisfy the one value of temperature. Now, if I ask to draw the solution in terms of a contours of temperature, what does it mean by contour? Contour is the line along which, or a space along which, the constant values are appearing. Okay. So suppose I draw a line now here on the wall. If I have to draw a contour line, how it will be? It will be a straight line, right? It will be a straight line. Similarly, on this wall, it is again straight line. Okay, because at all the boundaries, your contour value should be 0 and 1. That is what the elliptical is according to you. And now here, how the solution will evolve? Now it has to evolve. Solution should be such a way that it should be bounded by this 0 and 1 values, and as well as this insulating condition. So you see, the next level value will be greater than 0. Here, if you have a solution, this value will be greater than 0. So whatever this T value will be something like 0.1. Okay. And here, you see, here there is a perfect, perfect perpendicularity. Here there is a perfect perpendicularity. What does it mean? It means that the derivative, insulation means derivative at this location, dT by normal direction is y, so dT dy is 0. Here also dT dy is 0, normal direction is y. So it has to be 90 degree here. Suppose we have any other contour here, then it will also satisfy that. It should be perpendicular, means it should satisfy the boundary condition, and also it should be constrained by this value. So here it may be like a 0.5. Okay. Then again like that. Okay. So you see, the solution here in the domain is bounded by this boundary condition in elliptical cases. It is completely bounded by the elliptical. Okay. So that is what mean by elliptical. Now, let us come to the classification of this, just to briefly you. One, we was talking about hyperbole, right? One thing we were discussing about hyperbole, and in this case, what is the solution? What is the solution type? The solution type is wave-like. Okay, wave-like solution. And where to give boundary? Where to give boundary conditions? Where to give VCs? Boundary conditions, inflow boundary conditions only, inflow, okay, inflow BC, no boundary condition along the characteristics, no boundary conditions along the characteristics, inflow BC, okay. This is inflow. It also means no boundary condition, no BC along the characteristics. Curves, okay. In case of 2D, it is a line, and in case of 3D, that characteristic is the surface. Okay, mathematically, you can get this property. Okay. So, what is the characteristics? Characteristic is a line or a surface where you have the same solution and the continuity of the derivative do not exist. Like, for example, shock wave. Okay, so. Okay, so along that curve, the first derivative and second derivative do not exist. Okay, that is what the. Okay, next thing is. Let me just keep the line. And now about the solution, okay, about the domain of dependence. Domain of dependence. Domain of dependence. Dependence. So, domain of dependence, say we were talking about the 1D second order wave equation. In that case, suppose this was the x domain and we had a infinite domain, okay, with infinity, and we had a time derivative. So, we are moving in a time, like time direction. So there was a time direction, and we also know that there were characteristics. Okay? So based on the characteristics, we had a hyperbolic. In case of hyperbolic PD, we have two real characteristics. Two real characteristics. Okay, second order hyperbolic equation, we have two characteristics. Okay, if you have two real roots. Then you say that the particular PD is the hyperbolic PD. So we have a two characteristics direction. Okay. So what does it mean by that characteristics? Okay. Suppose we want a solution. So this is a time t. Okay, any time, and this is a x location. So we have given a boundary condition here. That is, those are initial conditions over all this t. For all this t, we know that the solution is known. All this x solution is known. Initial condition. Now with this initial condition, we would like to know at t is equals to some p plus delta t. P plus some delta t. Okay, what is the solution here? Now the solution at this location will be dependent on some value. This solution at this point can be taken from can it be evaluated from this value, or from this value, or from maybe from this value, or maybe from this value, or maybe from this value? Okay, so like that. So we have divided the domain, even in the time domain also we have a division. So it may, this point value may be dependent on other value, but in this case of hyperbolic problems, the solution. You have a solution here, it depends on the values which are in the domain of the characteristic curve. So at this point, there will be some characteristic curve. Characteristic will be moving. Say, for example, the characteristic moving in this point is this. Okay. if the characteristic is moving in this point, is so we know that there are two characteristics. This is the right running characteristics and left running characteristics for the second order hyperbolic PD. So domain of dependence in this case for this point, for this particular point, if you get the solution, the value solution at this point will be dependent on all the values which are coming within this region. Okay, understood? It depends upon the region covered by the characteristic curve passing through that point. So only these values will come into picture in giving the solution at this point. Suppose your scheme is having point from this region, this point doesn't have any impact on this value, the value at this point. Okay, value at this point is only dependent upon whatever you have a solution in this green region. Any other point will not, outside this domain of dependency, will not give you solution. This point will not give you solution. This point will not give you solution. This point values will not give you the solution. Okay, it is like supersonic case, supersonic flow problems, where you get a Mach cone. In the Mach cone region, if the aeroplane is moving, and when you are inside this Mach cone region, then only you are able to hear the noise. Otherwise, you are not able to hear the noise. Okay. So, any person standing here, and the plane is moving in the direction, he will not be able to listen unless and until that person comes under the domain of dependence. Okay. You got it? So, domain of dependency is the region covered by the characteristics passing through that one. In case of a parabolic PD, the solution is diffusion type. So diffusion type means if you have suppose for example you have a problem of suppose this is a ground level and there is a water, here. Okay, initially this water was stagnant and you immediately put some sort of a sleeve or lead. And you suddenly move that lead, then what will happen? Whatever the velocity, whatever the momentum or transferred from this top layer, it will be transferred into the another layers, okay, layer by layer. Okay, so you will see there will be a profile generation of this nature, like this. Okay, where you will have a higher velocity here. And then it will be diffusing with time, like that. So it will depend upon how much viscosity you have that fluid. Okay, so it will start getting inside. Okay, so that is like a diffusion process. Diffusion process is a molecular process. So there is an exchange of molecular activity here. So these are we know well known parabolic kind of natures. In heat transfer also, suppose you have subjected you have seen in that transient in the heat transfer lab where you were doing this transient convection problem and conduction problem. So there you see that such a kind of behavior. Initially there will be some distribution and then with passage of time or with passage of space, it will start diffusing. It will start flattening off. And where to give the BC here? Where to give the BC? So BC on there. You have to give BC. we have to give boundary conditions on all the boundaries. Initial condition, and initial condition is must. Okay, but you do not give the final condition in time. Okay, that will lead to the problem of which is called as you should not have the effect before a cause. A cause and effect relationship, that is called as causality principle. So that has to be there. So if you see some effect, it should have a cause. So you cannot specify the effect before you know the cause. So this initial condition act as a cause, and whatever you get a solution as an effect. So you cannot specify the effect. So we have seen in this case boundary conditions. Say for example, now again if I take a domain. So suppose if I take a domain, a 1D domain for example. So 1D domain means a line. So it is a bounded domain. Say for example, it is bounded. This is x equals to 0, and this x equals to some length, total l. So this line element of L. So if this is a kind of marching in time, so we have to take a time like direction. Now here you have to specify the boundary condition at x equals to 0. That is the one boundary. Another boundary at x equals to 0, you have to specify a boundary condition. And since we have a time like direction, we have to specify. Sir, can you draw? What was that? Can you draw? Just tell me by voice, because I can't go again and see the change the board.
Sir, can you draw the graphs a bit bigger?
Yeah, Michael.
Yes, sir. Can you draw graphs a bit bigger?
You are saying, can you draw
graphs bigger?
You were saying something about drawing. Can you draw the graph a bit bigger and explain?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is it not visible?
No.
Let's make it large. Yeah, is it fine now?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, Michael, I think I'm not able to hear you, but I think it is fine. Okay, so you have boundary condition, you have to specify boundary condition at this boundary and at this boundary also. At this boundary at x is equals to 0 and at this right boundary. At this right boundary, x is equals to that. And in time direction, you have to march. So you have to give initial condition at all the location. Okay. All the locations or grid points. All these grid points need to be given initial condition. So there will be initial condition at all these grid points. Okay. Now to know the solution at any other location. This location at t is equals to suppose t is equals to t plus delta t. Now what is the domain of dependence for this? So domain of dependence again is prescribed by the characteristics. Now in this case, in parabolic problems, you have a one characteristic, that is one real solution is there, one real root is there in the governing equation. So that is that characteristic is just a horizontal line. So this is one characteristic. Okay. So only one characteristic is there. So this is the characteristic passing through that point. So whatever the values below this characteristic curve will, so at the solution at that point will be affected by the region, green region, okay. Any region below the characteristic, below t is equal to, below t plus delta t. Okay, so all this region is a region of dependence for this solution. Solution at this point. Suppose you want solution at this point, you will have a characteristic line. Every point below that will be a will be affecting that solution. So at any lower t, you will have the same values of the grid points here. Okay, you are just moving in time, but space discretization is same. You have to understand that. Okay, just keep in mind. At any other point, we have, okay. So any t less than also will have dependence on this. Any solution in this, or at this t plus delta t will have dependence on any value at lower than t plus delta t. Okay. So this is the t equals to maybe 1 or 2 or 3, 4 like that. So solution at this point will be dependent on all the values at this previous time. This also, maybe this also, maybe this also at this t or any other t value. Okay, there may be many t values in between. So at this, the solution at this point will be dependent on all the points along this line, below this line. Okay, the solution at this point will be dependent on this point also. This point also. Any point below this. You understand domain of dependence? So this domain of dependence will be very important when you study when you do the discretization of PDEs using any scheme. Okay. In that case, it will be very, very useful. Next was our example of elliptic field, right? Elliptic PDE. So elliptic PDEs, we already said that they are like a the boundary conditions, all boundary conditions. We see the solution type is, excuse me. So elliptic PDEs, our solution was equilibrium type of solution, equilibrium solution. Okay, now you know what does it mean by equilibrium solution. And we see on all boundary conditions, on all boundary conditions has to be boundaries has to be given. Okay. And there is no initial condition required because there is no time dilution. No initial condition is required. No initial condition on time. No initial condition. No initial condition. On time. Okay. Or space. No initial condition on time or space. So it's like variable. time-like variable like space variable. Okay, so there we have to give all the boundaries. Okay, so what does it mean? So suppose we have a domain which I have already shown like a rectangle. Excuse me. So let me take the color. And we've already taken one. Some sort of a metal plate. Okay, it's a metal plate, for example. And here we said that there is some boundary condition. So all the boundary conditions will be here. We have to give all the boundary conditions on all the boundary conditions on all the boundaries. No initial condition in the domain. No need to any initial value specified over the domain. Okay, domain is discretized or maybe it can not be variable. If you are talking about the mathematical solution. If you are talking about CFD solution, it has to be discretized. So at every discrete location, we should know the initial condition in the cases of parabolic and hyperbolic. But in case of elliptic EPDs, there is no need of initial condition, no initial condition. Okay. Now solution at any point, in this is dependent on the boundary condition. Okay. Is dependent upon the boundary condition, not by the solution of this nearby. Okay. Okay. But here the point is again, it is described by the boundary condition. Okay. It has to specify boundary condition. So all the points, the domain of dependence for the elliptical problems become the boundary conditions and the region inside. Okay. So that is how it is. Okay. So domain of dependence is complete domain. So we just okay. The domain of dependence is the complete domain. This green region, the domain of complete region, bounded by the boundary, and completely dependent on the boundary condition, not on each. So this x variable, y direction, x direction, y direction. Okay, so this is how it is taking time to save the document. So you got to know the differences between all the PDs. Okay. I hope you are clear. So by now, you know. So hyperbolic, again, I would like to say with like solution, parabolic, you have diffusion solution, elliptic, equilibrium type of solution. You have to give the boundary condition, both boundary condition along the characteristic of boundary conditions on all the boundaries. Initial condition is must. We see on all the boundary condition, no initial condition is required, and domain of dependence is the reason covered by the two characteristics clause. The reason below the characteristic clause in parabolic, and in case of elliptical, all the region is the domain of dependence for any solution. Okay, so this domain of dependence is very important when you design any scheme. Suppose in your scheme you want to calculate values and you have taken the points outside. So in many schemes you have to take you calculate the solution at this point by taking the neighbor values. What is the neighbor solution? And from that you get the solution at this point. Okay, like that. So when you take neighbors outside this curve, these neighbors has no role in solution. So your neighbor, your scheme should be such a way that your neighbor will be always in this domain. If your neighbors are falling outside the domain, you will not get any solution at all. Okay, you will not get a solution at all. You understand? So to get a solution, we have to be very careful in case of hyperbolic problems. So hyperbolic problems are very, very complicated in that sense. Okay, but very easy in terms of Dorn equation, but very difficult in terms of the close, very easy in terms of Dorn equations, in terms of closure of the Navier-Stokes equations, but very difficult in terms of this particular part, shock wave capture, what the shock waves. Parabolic and elliptical degrees are little, so this hyperbolic is most complicated, parabolic are little bit, and elliptical are most easiest cases. Okay. You will get confirmed solution in case of elliptical. So, having said this, we'll go for. We know now that what is the importance of boundary condition. Okay? So we always said that in case of elliptic PDEs, we need to have inflow boundary condition, and like that. We were always saying. So what are boundary conditions? What types of what are boundary conditions? Okay, some conditions at boundaries. Those are we can say some boundary conditions. But what are the different types of boundary conditions? What are the types of boundary conditions available? Types of boundary conditions. Okay. Types of BC. Boundary conditions available. Types of BC. Okay. So there are majorly three types of boundary conditions. Okay, so mathematically they are called as, one is called as Dirichlet boundary condition. Dirichlet boundary condition. Okay, what is Dirichlet boundary condition? Suppose we have a domain. Okay, suppose this domain is described by B and this boundary B. So at B, this region, the curve is the boundary. So at B, you specify some value. Okay, say for example, you are finding a solution in terms of any phi variable, solution of phi. So at B, you have to specify the value of, so phi is specified. Phi is equal to specified value of phi. Okay. Some value specified. Some value has to be specified. Okay. So say for example, it can be G, any number has to be specified for phi at all the boundaries. If it is specified value, just one value, number, then it is called a Dirichlet boundary. And there is another boundary condition which is called as Neumann boundary condition. Neumann boundary condition. It is saving a document, is taking some time. I'll have to remove this auto saving option. It's consuming the time. Okay. Okay, so now even boundary condition. So again, you have a domain, for example, some other domain, okay, other domain, and you have a boundary, say gamma. So on this gamma, you need to specify, suppose one boundary condition, that is Neumann, then it is kind of a derivative. So derivative of that variable in that normal direction. So there is some normal, n normal vector, normal direction. So that del phi by del m, if you specify some value, okay, so say 0 or some value, okay, specified value. So I am just writing specified value like a heat flux, for example, heat flux. Okay, suppose you give heat flux or Qn, then specified, Q specified. That condition is also Neumann condition, because heat flux is nothing but del T by del X, okay, K dT by dX, minus K dT by dX. So like that. So if you have those kind of things where you have derivative specified in the normal direction, then it is called as Neumann boundary condition. This is also called as second type of boundary condition. This is called as first type of boundary condition. And there is a third type of boundary condition, which is called as Robin boundary condition. Robin boundary condition or mixed boundary condition. Mixed boundary condition. Mixed BC. Mixed BC means mixture of Dirichlet and Neumann. Okay. So this is nothing but mixture of Dirichlet. Mixture of Dirichlet and Neumann. D plus Neumann. So it will be like this. It will have a form like this. Alpha phi. Alpha is any coefficient of this variable phi plus some gamma coefficient again and derivative. So mixture of these two, some specified value can be a zero also, one or any other number. Okay. So if you have such a kind of condition, then it is called as Robin boundary condition. Okay. Example of this boundary condition you already might have seen. Suppose you have a domain where temperature has to be calculated, and you have been given a heat transfer coefficient, and also there is a conduction happening here on the wall. Okay, suppose on the walls there is a conduction and convection. In that case, conduction, this H value is a specified value. This H value will become a specified value, and the heat flux which is coming, that will be something of this form. So at this boundary conditions, it will be a mixture of these two combinations. Okay, Dirichlet combination plus Neumann combination. So these three type of boundary conditions you will see, which will have a such a kind of form. Then you have a some variable phi specified, some derivative of that phi variable along the normal direction specified, or the combination of phi variable and derivative specified. Sum of the phi variable and derivative in the normal direction of phi is specified. And alpha and gamma can be coefficient. Okay. If there can be some coefficients associated to these variables. And these are constants. Alpha and gamma are constants. They are not functions of phi or phi. Okay, so they are linear. This equation is linear boundary condition. Okay, these boundary conditions are linear. So we have to specify these the type of boundary condition. Okay, there are three types we have to specify. Okay, so I think it is already a time. I will stop here. Tomorrow we'll see what do we mean by the problem. Already we know that what we mean by problem. Okay then.
Out, 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 out.